welcome to this week's edition of International Wrestling. There are many wrestlers in the world today who have a great deal of charisma. You're looking at one who has that. He has class as well. Of course, we're talking about none other than the great Ritchie Martel. He's in action with International Wrestling this week. On his trail, with a lot of fury and 290 pounds to back it up, Steve Strong from Los Angeles. He's chasing Ritchie Martel, the great Samu. Large, destructive, and dynamic. Again, you'll see him this week with International Wrestling. Big news coming to you wrestling fans concerning the Long Riders. Stay with us. It's upcoming. To open up today, and of course featuring a young man that, as we have said in the past, you are very familiar with, that being of course your son in the blue tights outside the ring. Well, his partner Ron Ritchie starts in there with Frenchy Martin. Ritchie moving very, very quickly, and every time out, Gino, I have to say, I think I'm even more impressed with the capabilities of Ron Ritchie. I think, you know, that he and Gino Jr. could form a pretty dynamic young team.
I think so. He's a wrestler's wrestler, this Ron Ritchie. Has nice moves, good balance and leverage. Look at the way he moves against a veteran like Frenchy Martin. And the guy is well put together. That's what I like about him.
Well, he was showing us very, very good strength at that point until Frenchy Martin went to the hair. And you have to give it to Frenchy Martin. He is a wily and capable veteran. Knows all the tricks and probably even invented a couple.
Well, there he came up with a knee. Probably, you know, didn't hurt as much as it should have because Ron Ritchie's seen it coming, but still, just enough to take over and beat up on Ritchie.
Well, that punch to the midsection has it hurt Ron Ritchie, who's now whipped off the ropes.
Whoop.
Well, it looked to me like Frenchy Martin was going for an abdominal stretch, but a reversal is sunset flip, or no, I should say a roll-up by Ron Ritchie. Nice scoop by Ritchie and a slam. Frenchy Martin down heavily. Tagging off to the magnificent one, Richard Charland, arm dragged across the ring by Ron Ritchie. Into the corner now, the tag made. Here's Gino Brito Jr. Charland whipped off the rope, then a double hook, I guess, to the inside of the thigh.
That's right. I mean, I rarely seen that. I got to ask Jr., you know, what brought that on. Let's see what Junior's going to do against Charland. It's not the first time that they meet these two.
That's true, and there was a... Junior had a good arm bar. It was reversed by Charland. Headlock taken by Gino Jr. Whipped off the rope. Over top of Charland. What the heck? Charland.
Taken in the corner.
That attempted backdrop about a mile and a half away. Junior over very quickly. Went behind. Took him into his own corner. I thought Ritchie was going to tag and come in there, Gino.
I thought so, too.
Good shoulder block now by Charland. Putting Gino Jr. on the canvas. Over top of Brito. And... a nice leapfrog by Charland, but Junior over very quickly.
Okay, Milt. That's nice move, but no, I can't wait any longer.
Tag team action brings us tag team news.
Right.
Folks, you're well aware of the fact that the last number of weeks we have been telling you that the Long Riders, Scott Hogan and Wild Bill, had been given an ultimatum to put the championship belt on the line by a certain date or the belt would be lifted. Folks, in a way, I suppose that's good news. The date has come. The date has gone. The International Wrestling Championship Committee has decreed the Long Riders are no longer the International Tag Team Champs. Currently, we do not have tag team champions. The belts have been held up. And as Richard the Magnificent Charlotte re-enters the ring, we'll give you more news about that. The key thing, the Long Riders, no longer International Tag Team Champions. Side headlock, that was the news, wasn't it, Gino?
That was what I wanted to hear, and I'm sure the fans wanted to hear that, too.
Well, we know that the Long Riders are certainly in the hunt. I mean, they're better than in the hunt for the championship, after all. Even the Long Rider combination, the combination of Cowboy Bull Johnson and Wild Bill Irwin, who are still in the territory, are certainly a devastating combination. And obviously have to be considered, I would think, you know, the favorites for that championship. Well, what's going
what's
on now?
Double teaming Junior.
Right and Charlotte both in the ring. Junior with the crush and a double elbow to the throat.
Yeah.
Come on, Junior, get up there. What's the matter with the referee, Gino? I don't understand how he could have allowed that. Gino Brito Jr. suplex now, and that was a good suplex by Martin.
Very good suplex. That's a legitimate move, I must say.
Well, the cover by Martin. He hooked the legs, but Gino Brito Jr. kicked out from underneath. I wonder where he learned to dig down deep for that. Thumb to the throat. Brito Jr. now taken to the corner. Head rammed into the boot of Dick Charland. Up there on that top corner turnbuckle. Frenchy Martin tags off to Charland. Charland in a double punch to the midsection. And Martin lays a forearm in across, right now, across the kidney area of Gino Brito Jr. Snap there by Charland. Jr. over in the center of the ring. Down on the canvas. Charland's not moving like you're used to seeing him, Gino. He's generally the whirling dervish.
Yes, usually he dictates the pace. Maybe being tagged up with Martin. Martin, the old pro that takes his time, calculates everything. Oh, no good.
Went for the atomic drop, missed. Junior now, Martin up in the air. Atomic drop down heavily. But he's on Wadley Street, you know, and I'm talking about Junior because he did take punishment in there.
But he tagged out. That's the main thing.
Yes, he did. And the very impressive, relative newcomer here to International Wrestling, Ron Ritchie, with a very, very good move. After having with Frenchy Martin off the ropes, came across unique kind of a judo chop or now a double one to the top of Martin's head. Here's Charland. Oh, welcome to the ring and introducing yourself to Ron Ritchie. Charland now a reverse atomic drop down to the canvas. Ritchie was just...
We got four men in the ring now, Mills.
Yeah. Both of them in there. Charland, holy cow, would he go up high? What a backdrop by Ron Ritchie. And now, Ritchie has Charland in the corner. Brito Jr. has Ritchie Martin, but they each got thrown off. And Gino Brito Jr. down heavily on the canvas. Ron Ritchie taking punishment now by Ritchie Martin as Gino Brito Jr. is passed out through the rope by Big Dick Charland. Ron Ritchie now double whips across the ring. Underneath the attempt, a double clothesline and a double drop kick by Ron Ritchie.
Might be a pin here. Rolling
shoot
pin.
Shoot him a move. Yes. Yes, Ron Ritchie with that rolling pin. Grabbed the leg, flipped over top. You saw it, folks. The count of three went in, and that's all we got. You know, just that three count. I don't think that Frenchy Martin would have been down for longer than about another half a count.
No, no. Frenchy Martin was about to kick out, but fortunately for Ritchie and Brito Jr., the count was in.
I think really that the element of surprise had something to do with it. I think that Martin was surprised. You're going to see it now, folks. Look how Ritchie ducks. Double drop kick. Charland rolling out over to the other side of the ring. There it is, Ritchie over top. Just scored the count of three. Talk of a victory for Ron Ritchie. Gino Brito Jr. will be back.
Good. Glad to see the pioneer spirits alive and well in Canada, just like us. Cooking over open fires, roughing it under canvas, and you got the old Fosters to make it bearable. And you lucky beggars, they're selling the liquid gold for the same price as your regular brew. Just as well, too. Looks like some of you still have to go out and trap your own coats. Good on you, love.
Foster's Australian for beer, now brewed here.
Have a hot summer full of hit music. Music World got today's hottest albums at one sizzling low price. Get Billy Ocean's Love Zone LP or cassette for only $6.96. Plus, The Outfield, Jennifer Rush, and more, all for the same incredible price. And be sure to enter Music World's great summer full of music contest. You can win a swimming pool full of cassettes. Fill out a ballot at any Music World location and watch Toronto Rocks for more details. Make it a Music World summer, a summer full of hot music.
If you were your car and you needed a new muffler, you wouldn't go just anywhere. You'd go to Speedy. Speedy gives you a free estimate so you can relax. You get expert work and the Speedy guarantee. Try finding a better deal for big cars, small cars, whatever car you are. For a great price, call Speedy. At Speedy, you're not just another car. You're a somebody.
It's our food you'll always remember.
At Kentucky Fried Chicken, it's our taste that makes us famous. We alone have the Colonel's secret recipe of 11 herbs and spices. And we use only the finest, freshest ingredients to bring you a taste like no other chicken.
It's our food that makes us famous. It's our taste when you're having fun. It's our
put together, but what impresses me more, I wish seen a lot of muscle men going on, is that this guy is non-muscle bound. He can move, and he knows his wrestling. Unfortunately, he has decided to play it, you know, rough house it up. I mean, he likes to go in there and punish his opponent. Now, I'm tired of seeing guys like him wrestle young men that are just breaking in the game of professional wrestling. I want to see him against the Martels, the Bravos, the Road Warriors, you name them. It's about time, promoters, if you're listening. Give C. Strong the men that he deserves.
Well, I'll tell you something else, and it's not just give him the men that he deserves. Perhaps put him in a position where he may absorb some of the punishment that some of us think he may well deserve, Gino. Look at this, Gripley now, a young man attempting to break into professional wrestling, backed against the rope. Strong with not one or two, but three or four knees. And when I say big knee lifts, those are awfully big knees.
Everything he does, I'm sure, hurts. You're going to probably see it in this match where this guy can clothesline somebody, tear his head off. But look at this.
Put Gripley down very, very quickly, very heavily to the canvas. And look now, with the knee across the top of the chest, posing, flashing those muscles. You know, Gino, in the opening of the program, I referred to him as a sadist. And he really is a sadistic individual. He derives nothing but absolute pleasure from hurting his opponent.
That's right, he is a sadist. He likes it. I'm sure not. He could do away with it right now. If he'd want to right now, he could do away with Gripley. But no, he's going to punish him some more. And hopefully, I hope that kid doesn't get hurt. And the referee, let's see if the referee's going to do the job right.
Up in the air and down, that 290 pounds of elbow drop coming down across the upper chest of Jeff Gripley. And look again. Stopped him before the three counts, grabbed him by the hair after laying that leg across the chest and posing, showing those incredible muscles, awesome muscles, as he likes to refer to them.
That's right.
Gripley has spent virtually the entire
I've seen this before, Milt.
It looked like he was going to spring him across the ring, but Gripley, I think, made a mistake in grabbing the ropes, you know, and got his neck.
Maybe, but come on, Strong, give that kid a break.
No, you're talking to the wrong individual, Gino Brito. Come on. Strong now. Why don't the referees just count more quickly, Gino, and let's get guys like this disqualified?
But look, if you notice, Milt, he does push it to the limits, but he breaks when it's time. He doesn't want to get disqualified. He wants just to inflict pain, beat him up some more, and get that win in.
Oh, my goodness, now with that arm across the throat of Gripley, and he just dragged him down like a dog to the canvas, Gino. Gripley picked up off the canvas again by Strong. He's got him up in the air, holding him. Oh, power slamming him, 290 pounds of sadism is Steve Strong. power slamming Jeff Gripley to the canvas. I was going to say earlier, Gino, with the first body slam we saw in the match, body slam is the right description of what Steve Strong does. And there it is. There's that clothesline you were talking
about.
Stop
it dead in your tracks.
I mean, and that's legit.
It is legit. Especially that one.
That was the arm across the upper part of the chest.
Across the upper part of the chest. Good thing he didn't catch him on the nose or the throat with that one.
You really do have to be impressed by what Steve Strong can do in the ring, as well as by the way he looks.
Well, that's why. Let's get the big guns in. Let's see what Steve Strong can do against those guys. The Bravos. Bravos recovered now. Hey, I even would like to see a match Steve Strong against Men Mountain Moore, but I know that's impossible because the Creatchman's the way to finagle everything around. But still, the Warriors would be another match.
Oh, yes, it would. Finagle is a good word when it comes to the Creatchman family. No question. Jeff Gripley looks to me, Gino, like he's out on his feet.
He is. The kid, he's hoping right now to get pinned because, let's say, nobody likes to see that kind of punishment.
Well, hold it. He's been picked up now by Strong. Well, this has got to be the beginning of the end. There's a twist we haven't seen. Look at this. Strong just holding him up like he's a baby, upside down, the head between the knees. Look at the maniacal grin on the face. And now, Strong, he's turned once. He's turned a second time. He
Look,
wants
he's calling Martel.
Yep.
Rick Martel. He wants Martel.
Oh, cover up, and let's get the count of three, and let's get this mismatch over with. There it is, the count of three. Strong, once again, showing his muscles as referee Andre Waugh lifts his arm in victory. We're becoming accustomed to that sight. Of that, there is unquestionably no way you can avoid it. Look at the muscles. Awesome. I'll have to agree with Steve Strong, Gino Brito. He refers to his musculature and his development as awesome. What he has begun to accomplish inside that squared circle, one would have to also agree, is becoming awesome.
Come
but
on,
what?
Come on,
what's
Strong.
Going on now? There's no need for that.
No, he's not going to do that again.
Coming now, he's on the second turnbuckle. Gripley was just slammed again after taking that terrible, terrible pile driver. And from the second turnbuckle, Strong down. Now he's stomping him after that elbow drop, Gino, from the second rope. The referee, the officiating committee, look at this.
Repeat.
Look at this. A replay on it, folks. Folding Gripley up as if he was, as I said before, a baby. Ramming him upside down that top corner turnbuckle. Calling for Martel as he jumps around and shows the folks just how strong he truly is. This man is a sadistic maniac, in my opinion, Gino Brito, as we see that terrible pile driver delivered and chalk up a victory for Steve Strong. I know he's going to be very pleased with the result of that match. Let's hear from him now.
You know, wrestling fans, very seldom does a wrestler come to international wrestling or anywhere else for that matter and take it by storm the way a particular individual has done here lately. We're going to bring in now 290 pounds and it's all muscle from Los Angeles, California, Steve Strong. Mr. Strong, you have finally gotten your wish. And I think it's the fans' wish as well. You are going to meet inside that squared circle none other than former AWA World Heavyweight Champion, Ricky Martel.
The ultimate coward. I finally have him cornered. I went to his house. I begged everyone. I begged the Federation, please, have him sign the contract. They saw on TV. I challenged him. What did he do? He ran. He ran and hit him.
He had signed to wrestle another individual.
Wait. I challenged him. I went up there and said, Martel, let's go. What did he do? He ran.
He's a professional. You signed contracts to wrestle professionally.
He's a coward. That's all he is. He's a coward.
Well, we'll see about that. Do you honestly believe you'll be able to injure him the way you have others with your pile driver?
That's a given. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to get pleasure in it. I'm going to brutalize him. I'm going to give him this 23 right across his neck. And as his neck snaps back, I'm going to pick him up off the floor if there's anything left, which I doubt. I'm going to put him in the pile driver. I'm going to show all the little peasants in the arena exactly what's going to happen.
Wrestling fans and Mr. Strong, I would not take it as an axiom that you'll be able to lay that pile driver on Rick Martel. Fans, don't miss it. Folks, you know, good news following bad news. We see now how Steve Strong just absolutely brutalized and terrorized
and pulverized his opponent, Jeff Gripley. The good news is the match is signed. Steve Strong, you have received your wish, and sometimes, you know, wishes do turn into nightmares. Steve Strong, you are going to be meeting former AWA World Heavyweight Champion, the great Ritchie Martel. We'll see if you can pile drive him and injure him the way you have so many of your other opponents. I think it is the greatest of news that that match is indeed signed. Signed, yes. Sealed, yes. All that remains is for that match to be delivered. And delivered it shall be. Steve Strong, you challenged the former champion, and in my book, still a great champion, Ritchie Martel. The challenge has been accepted. Folks, don't miss it if you have the chance. Steve Strong.
Finally, a serious Molson Golden commercial. Serious because we're talking about how we make Golden so golden smooth. We do it here. You see, after we brew Molson Golden, we let it gently rest, aging it cold before we bottle it. That cold aging makes Molson Golden about as smooth as it gets. And that's a serious Molson Golden commercial.
Today.
That's an idea.
Oh, the Liberty Club.
Nice.
Isn't it? See? Completely automatic.
Very professional.
Oh, Dabber Bingo.
There are two Variety Club bingo palaces right on the Bloor subway line. You can play afternoons and evenings, 7 days a week.
Bingo?
Bingo!
Pizza?
Señores y señores, introducing McCain's Tenacris Mexican Pizza. As delicious as any Mexican dish you've ever tasted. The true Mexican flavors of ground beef, taco sauce with refried beans, mozzarella, and cheddar with hot sauce on the side.
Mucho bueno.
McCain's Tenacris Mexican Pizza.
Gracias, McCain.
Ever take your car in for service, and they say you need this, and they say you need that? How do you know? I took my car to Goodyear Certified Auto Service, and they said...
We don't guess. We get the facts. Our new computer runs over 100 tests on your car in minutes.
Instead of this or that, I got one of these. A printout showing exactly what my car really needed.
You get it only where you see this sign. Goodyear Certified Auto Service. We don't guess around.
International Wrestling's going to have a TV champion. You're going to choose the contestants. Write and let us know who they should be. International Wrestling, 4000 Beauvian East, Montreal, H1X186. Without question, Gino Brito, one of the most rapidly rising young stars throughout the entire world of professional wrestling. And we have big, big news for the wrestling fans about Mr. Zenk.
Well, yes, Mr. Zenk finally got himself a partner. Dan Kroffat, he asked him as a favor, please be my partner, because if you remember, Milt, he had teamed up with a young guy by the name of Watt, which the guy lacked a little bit in experience. And
so did the Canadiens goaltender by that same name.
That's right. But let's face it, Zenk did take a beating from the Long Riders, but now it should be a different story.
That's right. Not only, though, did he get Dan Kroffat as a partner, as a result of the decision taken by the Championship Committee of International Wrestling in stripping the Long Riders of the Tag Team Championship belts, the belts now held up. The finalists, as determined by that same championship committee, that should square off for
the championship. We're determined to be the new long rider combination of Cowboy Bull Johnson and Wild Bill Irwin. The other finalists from the recently held tag team tournament, Alofa and Jack Kroffat, were offered to be the contestants against that combination. The three of them, Alofa, Zink, and Kroffat, sat down together inasmuch as Kroffat had agreed to be Zink's partner in Zink's effort to gain retribution against the Long Riders, and certainly Zink and Alofa had no love for those guys either. It was decided by Alofa that he would step aside so that, folks, and get this and listen to me, and you're going to love it. Next week, right here on International Wrestling, the International Tag Team Championship belt will be on the line when the combination of Wild Bill Irwin and Cowboy Bull Johnson face the combination of Dan Kroffat and Tom Terrific, Tom Zink. And that'll be right here on International Wrestling on television next week.
Should be a doozy, Milton. I'm looking right now at Tom in action. So far, he's been controlling the matches. It's been going all his way, work, and you know, every week I keep watching this guy work. And every week I can see that the guy gets refined, gets better, because he sticks to wrestling. He gets to know his holds better, he's more confident of himself, and that's why that him and Dan Kroffat should be the team. Now, don't get me wrong, I believe that Bull Johnson and Bill Irwin are just as vicious and mean and just as capable as was Bill and Scott. But against these two, maybe we'll get up there.
Well, I'll tell you something. You look at the way Zink is performing in the ring during the course of this match. Granted, Proulx is a little raw, but he's game. But he has not really put a hold on Tom Zink so far during the entire course of this match. Tom Zink has been in absolute control from moment one. And at this time is, and you know, while they're on the canvas and we're talking about, let's say, that newest Long Rider combination of Wild Bill Irwin and Bull Johnson, Cowboy Bull Johnson, I'm wondering, Gino, if perhaps a rumor that I heard that has some validity as to why Scott Hogg Irwin hasn't been around for a while. What I heard was is that there was a family fight, a feud, whatever you want to call it, between the two brothers, Scott Hogg and Wild Bill, and that the being away on business was Bill Cowboy, or Wild Bill Irwin, just didn't want to admit that he and brother Scott Hogg had a falling out, brother to brother.
Could be, but as far as I'm concerned, I think it was a grain of salt. I believe it's just rumors. Somehow, somewhere, he's going to spring up.
All right, well, you hadn't heard that.
I haven't heard about that.
Well, okay, unconfirmed rumor,
no.
Folks.
Even if it's true, they're blood brothers, they're going to patch things up, that's for sure.
Right this moment, it is an unconfirmed rumor, and that's why I was asking if you had heard anything about it. However, it remains unconfirmed, but we do want to pass along a little gossip to you folks.
A little surprise here.
Yeah.
But
Zink over top of that beautiful leapfrog and a flying body press. Beautifully done by Zink, and that, I think, Gino, might have been all she wrote had he not just been too close to the ropes. And justifiably, the referee broke it.
Saved by the ropes.
Whipping through now. There it is. There's the Tom Zink sleeper. Nighty night, Ludger through. That's got to be it. Well, some folks, you know, have to take the Valium, others take night off. Guys like Ludger through just get slapped into Tom Zink's sleeper hold. And they start counting sheep. And I wonder what number Ludger Proulx's at now, because he's down and out. Zink covers him and for good measure hooks the leg. Referee down, the count of three goes in. And you know, this is becoming a very happy and familiar sight. See Tom Zink's hand raised in victory here on International Wrestling, as it has just been. Well, it's morning already, Ludger. I'll tell you, this guy is an exciting young performer. We see that beautiful flying body press that Tom Zink laid in, and that, Gino, that really could have been it had he not been so close to the ropes.
However, it could have been a pin, but why not do it this way?
Do it.
You make sure you put him to sleep, and after he's sleeping, put him down, and then and add insult to injury, cover him for the 1-2-3.
And you know something? Tom Zink just shows you he's learned his lesson well. He didn't take anything for granted. He hooked the leg when the three count went in. Wrestling fans, lots more action coming up. We're going to ringside now, talking to Kroffat and Zink. Wrestling fans, as you're aware, there is tremendous competition, tremendous rivalry here with International Wrestling. I'm going to bring in now one of the bright lights of the entire world of professional wrestling, Tom Zink. Tom, nope. Your rise has been meteoric. The fans are all on your side. But I have a couple of questions for you. Both of them concern the Long Riders. A, do you have any idea, have you heard any rumors, where Scott Hager or when might be? And B, we heard the Long Riders get on your case, call you all kinds of names, challenges were issued. I think your emotions perhaps ran away a little with you. You chose as a partner a young wrestler who perhaps didn't have the experience to cope. But, you know, what is it with these guys?
I don't know. In answer to your question number one, Scott Hagerwin, I don't have a clue to where he's at. Maybe you're right, Milt. Emotions ran wild. I was hot. They stuck the finger in my chest. They called me a chicken. They called me every name in the book. But I'm not going to back down from anybody because I'm on my way to the top and I'm climbing the ladder. But I only thank God when they double-team me, that's two on one, that this man, and I'd like to bring him in right now, Dan Kroffat, came to my rescue.
Welcome, Dan.
Because things could have been a lot worse.
Dan, you jumped into Tom's aid when the Long Riders were double-teaming Tom.
Yes. Hey, I've been had a lot of experience with these guys, and it's the same story every time. They're not trying to hurt you. They're trying to cheat you. And, boy, I got fed up. When I seen them double-tagging on them, because I had a past experience like that, they try to kick my face off with a loaded boot. Well, let me tell you, there's got to be justice now. You know, me and Tom, we had a long talk last week, and we both have something in common. We want the Long Riders, and I heard, hey, Tom, I heard some good news. The International Wrestling Committee is making put up their belts on TV next week, and let me tell you.
Well, you said you had a talk. Does that mean you've decided to tag up as partners?
That's right. We've decided to tag as partners, and next week, like he said, it's going to be...
New tag team combination, folks.
People are always making up stories about big guys like me. Like I change flat tires by lifting up my car. Or I eat two steaks and a dozen eggs for breakfast. Come on. But there's one thing I'm very big on. Miller Lite. Lite tastes great. And what's important, tastes less filling than regular beer. But a dozen eggs, I wouldn't have room for lunch.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
And hey, I've never lifted a car. I drive a truck.
I put a good 150 miles a year of stop and go driving on my car. Quarter mile here, quarter mile there. It adds up. So I use Lens friction-proofing engine treatment. Adding a bottle with every oil change helps stop oil breakdown and oil burning. Lens has added protection and insurance that helps me run cooler and smoother. And if Lens does all that to my $100,000 race car, just think what it can do for this race.
Friction-proofing is available at Canadian Tire Towers, Kmart Performance Improvements, and Wilco.
About six shampoos from Clairol.
No joke, give me the money.
Every Tuesday and Thursday, City Pulse recreates a crime police need your help to solve.
Come on now, give me the money.
If you can help, call 222-TIPS, Crime Stoppers. It works because you care.
Jim Londos in there, and can you believe it, folks?
announced the 220-pound man, Mountain Moore at 348 pounds. You know, we're talking about 128 pounds weight differential.
That's just too much, I mean, for Jim Londos. The man also, besides not making the weight, let's face it, who does against Ben Mountain Moore? Experience-wise, it's just not there.
You know, and it's too bad because Jim Londos does have some wrestling talent and ability. We just saw some good, quick moves right off the top, even though he had been goaded, and maybe it worked to his advantage. He got his adrenaline going by pretty boy Floyd Creatchman, the manager, or as he likes to be referred to, the number one sports agent. Londos showed some good, quick moves, went between the legs and Moore threw a beautiful drop kick, and Moore didn't flinch.
Well, Moore is a big man. You see, at 340 pounds or so.
348.
348 to be exact, yes. Now, what can a man like Londos, a guy like Londos, I'm sure, does not wrestle that often. So right away, he's not in the groove of things. To go in against Moore kind of cold, it's tough for anybody.
Well, you know something, you talk about grooves. There could be one in the small of his back right now after the way he was rammed into that top corner turnbuckle upside down by Man Mountain Moore. He is a biggie. 66 and a half inches tall and 348 pounds. And since that opening flurry by Jim Londos, it's been all Man Mountain Moore, and what a power slam that was, Gino. All 300 and close to 50 pounds of Man Mountain Moore coming down, and look at that body slam. That's a long way to come down and hit the canvas.
That's right, and Man Mountain Moore, I've looked through some records. He's been on a winning streak so far. Hasn't lost too many matches. Look at that.
Drops across that rope is Jim Londos by Man Mountain Moore. Pretty boy Floyd looking just pleased. His punch outside the ring. That could have been a devastating move on Londos by Man Mountain Moore if he had caught that flush on the Adam's apple of the trachea, Gino, because it could have decapitated him virtually.
You're right, Milt. And right now, you know what I'm thinking? Man Mountain Moore, after all the talk and yelling and the screaming, where's Bravo? Well, Bravo has finally arrived. I can tell you that Dino Bravo is ready, and that should be a match.
Well, this should be it. As Man Mountain Moore has got Londos up there, the bell's gone, a submission with that hangman or backbreaker, and you're absolutely right, Gino Brito. Your former partner, that great Dino Bravo, international heavyweight champion, is he fully recovered from that terrible
without a doubt, Milt, he is recovered. There's the victory. Well, we called it, didn't we?
Yeah.
And Mountain Moore should have an easy time against...
Well, and he did, but we'll see it again, but while we're looking at it, he will not have an easy time with the international heavyweight champion, Dino Bravo. Gino, very, very few people in professional wrestling know Dino as well as you. After all, you were his tag team partner.
I would hope so. I started Dino Bravo in professional wrestling. I know everything there's to know about Dino Bravo. Right now, I can tell you he's ready.
Well, I'll tell you, and Dino Bravo has had great success against large opponents. You heard it here. Dino Bravo has signed to face this giant of a man. Man Mountain Moore, folks, will bring you up to date on that. Stay with us. Much more action coming up. Indian ass throughout the world, and right now cutting a swath through Japan like a samurai sword, the great Samu. He's in action. He's next.
There are a lot of controversial happenings, wrestling fans, as you're all aware, going on here with international wrestling. Of course, we're all wondering exactly where is Scott Hogg Irwin. One of the other controversies recently begun, we're going to bring in one of the individuals, of course, Rick Martel, one of the bright lights of professional wrestling throughout the entire world. Rick, the fans and I are all aware of the challenges that are being hurled out to you, almost interference that's been perpetrated by Steve Strong during your matches. He's challenging you everywhere. As you said, you're not going to be used as a stepping stone. But Ricky, how are you going to stand for it?
Well, you know, Milt, challenges is the name of the game in wrestling as in any other sports. You know, and I love challenges. I love them, you know, because when I first joined the AWA, for instance, you know, I wanted, you know, put a challenge to me was to become the world champion, AWA world champion. And I did do that. But now I have another challenge. This man, Steve Strong. Yes, he is big. I've never seen a man as big as him. I've never seen a man as vicious. The guy goes through his opponent. I mean, he just walks over them and he does anything he wants. I mean, the man is very powerful. But you know what I say, Milt? The man can give it, but can the man take it? That's what I say. And if he wants me, well, here I am. You know, I ain't going to go. I'm not going to run away from him.
Well, that's a valid point, Rick. And we all know you won't run away from him. But he has been hurling these challenges. Look, a very quick way for him to make a big name for himself in wrestling would be to defeat Ricky Martel.
Yes, it was. You know, in a way, Steve Strong reminds me of this balloon right here, you know? You know, I mean, he comes to international wrestling, yes, he gets big. And he gets bigger. The man pumps himself with hot air. But you know one thing, Steve Strong, like this balloon here, when you get too big, I mean, it bursts. So you just better watch out, because here I am, and come and get me, because I ain't going to run away from you. And
stay with us, folks. We'll be right back. The great Samu, one of the most naturally talented young wrestlers in the world today, in demand worldwide and currently on a tour of the Orient, the entire Far East, and in fact, traveling virtually around the world before returning here to International Wrestling the end of June. Wrestling fans, the great Samu is compiling a winning streak unparalleled in the world of wrestling, and he's compiling that winning record throughout the entire world. He has served notice to the promoters of International Wrestling that he is returning the end of June, and returning with one thing on his mind and one thing only, and that is for the sole and specific purpose of capturing the International Heavyweight Championship. The great Samu is destroying wrestlers in Japan. He intends to destroy wrestlers in Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, and to cut that swath throughout the world, all the way back here to international wrestling. He wants the International Heavyweight Championship belt like he has never wanted anything in his life. He has said when he achieves that International Heavyweight Championship, the next time he travels the world, he will make even more money and have even more girls chasing him. The end of June, folks. The time is short, and the great Samu is returning to international wrestling. He is without question championship caliber material, as I said before, and as recognized by every wrestler in the world, as recognized by every wrestling expert. One of perhaps the most naturally gifted, naturally talented professional wrestlers that exists today. The great Samu is not only talented, he is large and he is dangerous. After all, he is 64 inches tall and 275 pounds. He has achieved a modicum of success unparalleled. He is learning new holds, new devastating and destructive holds at all times. You just saw one right there. The great Samu, you have seen him in action before. It will be interesting to see what additional tricks and maneuvers he has learned on his recent world tour. But the end of June, folks, is coming soon. And the great Samu returns to international wrestling looking for the championship.
Pretty boy Floyd Creatchman here. You all just saw the tape of the great Samu in action. He's in the Orient right now, but he's going to be here in the near future for only one purpose. We want Dino Bravo, the International Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, because all the biggest stars, they're all over here. But the cream of the crop is the great Samu with his sports agent, pretty boy Floyd Creatchman. The great Samu, no destruction. You can't stop him. You can't hurt him because he moves. He's fast. He's tough and he's strong. With my intelligence, brains, and knowledge, combined with his ability, agility, size, power, it's unbelievable. Bravo, you're going to walk into the ring. I don't know when, but it's going to come up in the near future. You're going to have to put your belt on the line, and we're going to go down in defeat for the three count, because anybody that faces the great Samu, you never know what he's going to do. You never know what he's going to do, because he has a lot of surprises. No, I don't got tricks up my sleeve, but we got a lot of plans for you, Bravo, and you're going to be forced to step in the ring, whether it be Montreal, United States, Ontario, it don't matter. You're going to come in the ring and face the great Samu, and we're going to make you look so bad in front of the people. We're the people's choice, the great Samu, the future heavyweight wrestling champion.
What a way to start a holiday.
Grabby Mugler broke clean out.
Here, you minus boys are good. We'll prove it. That's great, Top Gun, but can you get the wagon rolling fast?
At Midas, fast comes with the territory.
Fast? But is it good?
Midas guarantees it, right across Canada and the States.
Move it!
Wagon, ho!
A little peace of mind goes a long, long way.
Finally, a serious Molson Golden commercial. Serious because we're talking about how we make Golden so golden smooth. We do it here. You see, after we brew Molson Golden, we let it gently rest. aging it cold before we bottle it. That cold aging makes Molson Golden about as smooth as it gets. And that's a serious Molson Golden commercial.
Absorbean invites all hard-working Canadians to rub it in.
Rub it in, rub it in.
Absorbean, a big rub-it-in remedy for sore, aching muscles. With deep, penetrating action that gets under your skin fast for soothing relief.
Put it on my back, my back will really act.
Absorbean, liquid and crisp.
Rub it in, rub it in.
Which way to the beach? You've won seat tickets for wearing your Toronto tee today.
Oh, great. Thank you very much.
Finally winded, I'm wearing my shirt.
What do you say?
Wear your Toronto tee and be watching for Ziggy this summer. She's got free tickets for concerts at Kingswood Music Theatre, Canada's Wonderland.
I told you to wear this today. Thank you very much. This is great.
I love Toronto.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Ziggy. Oh, my God, I love you.
Wrestling fans, as we've been telling you, there is a tremendous amount of controversy surrounding certain aspects here of international wrestling. One tidbit of information that I have been asked to pass along to you, the wrestling fans, is this. As a result of not having defended their tag team championship belt...
Wait a minute, Just wait 1 second. Let me tell the people. They have taken our belts away. They have held the belts up. The people of Canada cannot come up with a talented enough team to get in the ring with the Long Riders. So consequently, the Long Riders have not defended their belts within the specific amount of time.
You were given
Sorry about my English there, but I couldn't get it
out. You were given opportunity after opportunity and deadline after deadline.
Now listen, no deadlines were put up that we couldn't meet. We were always ready to defend those belts and all the chicken-livered, lily-livered, lop-eared Mickey Mouse cheap impersonation of wrestlers that they have around here would not get in the ring with us.
Now, where is Scott Hogger?
Everybody's yellow.
Where
They're
is
just
Scott
scared
Hogg
to get into the
now,
ring.
Now, I have told you and I have told the people out there, Scott Hogg is taking care of some business. When there's some business up here to take care of, he will be here to take care of the business.
Next week, the belts have been held up. Next week here on television, you and you, the new Long Rider, Irwin and Cowboy Bull Johnson and Wild Bill Irwin will be wrestling in a combination yet to be named for the International Tag Team Championship.
Well, you know, that's just fine. You know, the championship committee is finally going to force some Canadians to get in the ring against the Long
Next
Riders.
Week, wrestling fans, Cowboy Bo Johnson and Wild Bill Irwin will be wrestling here on television for the Tag Team Championship.
Who should square up for the TV championship? You tell us. Wait us now. International Wrestling, 4000 Beaubien East, Montreal, H1X1H6. Get your letters in.
Martel, Diamond Jim, the referee calling the ring center.
He's approaching the ring.
What's going on?
Steve Strong, there he is.
What's he got to say? Challenge wants to get in the ring right now with Ricky Martel. You know, this is absolutely ludicrous, Gino Brito. The match is already signed. He knows that. He's not content to wait until the dates are put on the dotted line. Let's see what Ricky has to say. Well, Martel just told him, here I am, anytime you want it. But you know something? Steve Strzok can come out and challenge all he wants. Ricky Martel can accept all he wants. But there's no way that the promotion
could allow the match to happen at this particular moment because Martel has signed a contract to wrestle Diamond Jim.
Right you are, Mills, and this is ridiculous. Steve Strong knows he's got that match signed against Martel. What's he trying to do there? Play on his nerves?
I think he's
anyway,
trying to
psych. Martel right there is taking a chance. Because let's face it, he's no pushover, that Diamond Jim. Look at the size of him. Now,
big
he
guy.
Can't afford to turn his back on Steve Strong. How can he concentrate on his match with that big guy there?
Well, it does make it tough. There's no question of that, Gino Brito. And now, look, Diamond Jim conversing with Steve Strong, Strong wishing him luck, and that maybe has to make you look at that. Diamond Jim throwing his jacket in the face of Ricky Martel after talking to Steve Strong. I'm just wondering, Gino Brito, whether these two guys, Diamond Jim, obviously he shook hands with Steve Strong, obviously maybe trying to be Strong's friend, I don't know.
Maybe trying or be his tooth or something else.
Maybe a couple of bucks.
There is no place for Steve Strong around the ring. And if he would make a move, I would hope that the referee would disqualify right there, stop that match, and give the victory to Martel.
Well, yes, because you're right. This is almost a handicap match in a way if Strong stays at ringside, you know. Martel has to be concerned not just about Diamond Jim. Look at the size of the guy.
Big man.
Side headlock taken by Diamond Jim. And there we see Steve Strong. And he is a sadist. We said it before. Hovering in the background. Right on the other side of the ring. Good side headlock taken by this guy, Diamond Jim.
Well, so far, yes, he is a big man. But still, I mean, if I was a betting man, which I'm not, Mills, I would put my money on Martel because of the experience. Because it goes way back from the AWA belt on down. Rick Martel is the man right now to be reckoned with. And I'm going to be there at ringside when he finally steps into that ring with Steve Strong.
Well, that's for sure. But as I said, this is almost a handicap match because Martel really has to have his wits about him. He's wrestling a large opponent. The guy is a professional wrestler. At the same time, he almost has to have eyes in the back of his head to keep his eyes open. You never know what Strong's going to do.
Well, right now, Strong is standing about 60 feet from the ring. That's where he should stay.
Yes, but you know something? We saw Rick Martel lose his AWA World Heavyweight Championship belt. Well, that's good. Well, I was going to say, we saw Martel lose his AWA World Heavyweight Championship belt as a result of having been injured by Stan previously. Hey, Strong, as he invaded the ring, even if he got fined, you know, that could perhaps inflict damage that might enable him to defeat Martel when they do meet.
Well, Martel just wouldn't step into the ring because he did it once before, stepped in the ring too soon, and it almost cost him his career.
Big! Heavy body slammed by this big guy, Diamond Jim.
He's big, no doubt about it.
Martel down heavily, and I have to wonder, you know, whether or not his mind is more preoccupied with Steve Strong than it is perhaps with the job at hand, which is to take care of Diamond Jim, his opponent in this match. As Martel is whipped across the ring, holy cow, what a kick. Diamond Jim put that right smack dab on the jaw, hit the canvas hard. Martel ramming Diamond Jim's head to that top turnbuckle, whipping him now across the ring. Diamond Jim over, backdrop by Martel. You can hear that the fans are solidly behind this great champion wrestler, Ricky Martel, as he body slams Diamond Jim, backing him against the ropes and whipping him. There's the Martel dropkick. Diamond Jim down heavily on the canvas. Martel over top. He is on fire today, isn't he, Gino?
I have a feeling. He's setting him up. You know, for what, Mills?
Yeah, dropped out across the knees. Only one man in the world does this, folks, and you just saw him do it. That's Ricky Martel springing in over that top rope from the ring apron outside, covering the man, hooking the leg. The count of three goes in. Ricky Martel scores another victory here on International Wrestling. There's the slam. This is a gorgeous move that Ricky has developed, isn't it, Gino?
I like it because he always ends it, look, with a drop kick. Now he's going to go for that backbreaker, set him up, and that dive, that spectacular dive, I mean, that's lights out.
It's unique, it's classical, and it's Ricky Martel because there's nobody else, folks, in the whole world that does this. Over the rope, cover the man, hook the leg. Ricky Martel makes another victory. Stay with it. Wrestling fans, you're aware of all the controversies here at International Wrestling. Steve Strong, Ricky Martel, Man Mountain, Moore, Dino Bravo, the Long Rider controversy.
You're aware of the great new faces that have come here. Steve Strong again. Tom Terrific, Tom Zenk. Returning to international wrestling, a very capable, a very competent professional wrestler, a man I've known for quite some time. Very, very changed, Bob De La Sera, since I first got to know you. Other than the fact that you had a lot more hair at that particular point.
Let me just say one thing, Milt, please. Very changed what you say.
That's correct.
No one's asked you your opinion.
Bob De La Sera,
I've asked you your opinion about me.
True.
But
Bob De La Sera, I've always...
Let me tell you something right here. All of you wrestlers here out in the international circuit, Bob De La Sera is back. I've been all over the world. You name it, Japan, the Caribbean, Germany. Just last month, I wrestled a European champion and beat him. All right, I'm not European. I cannot call myself the European champion. But in my heart, I am the European champion. Now, I hear of names of Ricky Martel, ex-world champion, Tommy Zenk, Dan Kroffat, all world-class wrestlers. Well, Bob De La Sera is back. Yeah, I've changed. Because all this technique, all these fair holds, didn't get me nowhere. I've learned the hard way. Scars on my shoulder, on my knees, on my back. I'm back here to wrestle, to win my matches, to come out victorious, to make some money, and to come out with some championships. When Bob De La Sera steps into that ring, it's eye gouging, it's kicking, it's fighting, it's finagling, conniving.
You know, wrestling fans, it's too bad because this man was a nationally ranked amateur wrestler. He could be a great wrestler. We'll be back with all kinds of action. Wrestling fans, there's always tremendous action, thrill shows, thrills, and excitement here this week with International Wrestling. You've seen this segment before. There's a reason we're all looking at it again. Let's just remember the tidbits of information, great information, I feel, that was passed along today. Dino Bravo, back strong as ever. He will be looking, folks, believe me, for revenge for all those disgusting words and insinuations that were made about him by that giant man-mouth. Lord Gino Bravo has signed to meet him. Ricky Martel, hey, finally fed up with all the challenges issued to him by 290-pound statistics, Steve Strong, and that's all signed. Martel to meet Strong and young Tom Terrific, Tom Zenk. Remember, folks, next week on television right here.
Summer's here. It's time for the new Toronto Tees. Great new styles, bold new colors. Get your Toronto Tees exclusively at Stitches and make this the hottest summer ever.
Until next week, I'm Milton Breskin for Gino Brito and all of us in International Wrestling. Have a good week.
I'm Daniel Richler. Be here tonight at 10:30 for a special New Music Encore presentation of The Arrows live in concert.